I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground.
So recently I ordered two custom saddles from Barnes Tack Room for Milo and I. One of them is the dressage saddle, which is called the Debonair, and this is the one that I'm going to show you first. It's made completely from calfskin leather, so it's really nice and soft and sticky, and it holds you in a really good position because of this. It keeps you in such a good place. Your legs don't really move at all because of the leather. I love calfskin leather, even though you have to do a bit more to take care of it than you would with grain or buffalo leather, but it's cheaper than buffalo and it's a lot stickier than grain, so it holds you in a lot better than if you're used to riding in grain leather saddles. Milo is a medium wide tree, and then the panels were also adjusted slightly to fit him custom, and then when the saddle got here I got the wool flocking adjusted by my fitter just to make sure it's completely custom fit to him. I did leave the flaps regular length because I felt that I didn't need a long flap in a dressage saddle, and I was correct. It fits my leg really, really well, and I'm super happy with it. This saddle is a monoflap saddle, and they do have the billets attached higher up, which means that it's more stable and holds the saddle down onto the horse from a better point of balance. So it fits him really, really nicely, and it's really secure against him for a really nice close contact feel in a dressage saddle with a deep seat. So it holds you in and makes you feel comfortable, but you can still feel the horse really well. I chose to get the logo embossed because I feel that it's classier, and that's just my personal preference. You can also get it sewn on, you can get contrast stitching, and you can really customize these saddles to look exactly how you want them to. I opted just to get the regular black stitching. However, I did get the contrast stitching on my jumping saddle. The price for this saddle is $2,800 US. And that includes customization, which is a really good price for a custom saddle, especially for the quality of leather that these have. And I understand that's not in everyone's price range, but if you are going custom, that's probably the lowest you can realistically spend and still get a decent quality saddle. So I would highly recommend these if you're looking to go custom on a budget. And then obviously you can use my code for a further discount of $280 off of that price because it's for 10% off. And I will link information for that in my bio. And then I got the cross-country saddle, which is called the Valor saddle, and I got it in dark brown with contrast stitching. This usually does come in a monoflap, but I got it dual flap because I wanted to use a regular girth with it, and then I got the blocks put on the outside still because that's the look that I liked, and I felt like they did more when they're in that position. I got the deep seat for this one. And like the dressage saddle, this one is a medium wide tree for Milo, and I got it flocked to fit him perfectly, and I also got the panels adjusted to fit him as best they can. I absolutely love this saddle. As you guys know, my other jumping saddle was also by Barnes Tack Room, but I definitely prefer this one over the Sauté. Both are nice saddles, but I just feel like this one is definitely more up my alley look-wise, and I also like how it feels a lot better. This saddle is also full calfskin, so it's really nice and sticky and holds you in really well. And like the other saddle, it is a more delicate leather, so it does need to be taken care of pretty well, and it will wear faster than buffalo leather, but that goes for any calfskin saddle. I really love calfskin, and it's pretty much all I've bought for my saddles in the last several years. The nice thing about both of these saddles is that they're really wide through the channel, and this means that they'll fit most horses a lot better. So many tack brands do not have a wide enough channel, and then the saddles end up sitting directly on the spine. So I'm really happy about these saddles and how wide the channel is, because it means that it's going to fit a way wider variety of horses. And most saddle fitters will tell you that super narrow channels virtually don't fit any horse at all. Even though I'm short, I'm really long from hip to knee, so I did the advanced flap on this saddle, which is a longer and more forward flap, and it fits my leg very, very well. The best out of pretty much any saddle I have ever had, so I would highly recommend that if you have long legs. And like on the dressage saddle, I got the logo embossed on this one just because I prefer the look better. And then the other thing that I will touch on quickly is that even though it's called the cross-country saddle, it does function as a normal jumping saddle. So before anyone says anything about the fact that I'm not an event rider, this was just a personal preference, and it gives me everything I need, whether or not I'm doing cross-country or show jumping. So I really do love this saddle, and I would recommend it to anyone, whether or not you're an eventer or a show jumper. For the hunter ring, this would be more untraditional, so it might be something that you want to stay away from if you want to stay traditional. So anyways, if any of you guys are looking for a more affordable way to go custom, I would recommend this brand, because obviously some of the more popular brands get you up to like $8,000 for a custom saddle, which personally I think is pretty ridiculous. So if you're looking to save some money but still get something that is quality, I would recommend checking out some of these saddles. And if you do decide to order from them, feel free to use my code to get 10% off. It's just SDEQUUS, SDEQUUS. So if you use that at the checkout, you will get 10% off your entire order. So it would save you some more money. And I totally know what it is like to be on a budget. For the longest time, I did not have nice tack at all. It was all very, very well used and very cheap. So I'm very fortunate to be working with a company like this and to have access to custom saddles at this sort of price, because otherwise I guarantee you I would not be able to afford it. So I hope you guys get something out of this for trying to shop higher end things at a more affordable price than what you can get the vast majority of higher end tack. I also hope that you guys enjoy some of the photos and videos that I put from Milo and I's recent cross-country schooling. It was only a week after that last show that I posted the video of, and I really felt like it was good for him. He gained so much confidence and was so bold by the end of it. So I'm feeling really good about things now, and I'm planning on taking him off property schooling for jumping once a week if I can. I've been practicing driving the trailer, and I think I'm more comfortable taking it out on shorter trips now. So hopefully there will be more off property schooling coming in the future.